Alana. This is ridiculous. It's been 3 days and we haven't said a word to each other.
I know. We have to talk.
Well, about what you said. I mean, the part about being in love with me. I realized you were suffering from oxygen deprivation and we were literally seconds away from death. So I know you probably didn't mean it.
No, I meant it. But I don't expect you to reciprocate. Really, you can just pretend that I didn't say it. In fact, let's just forget that I even said anything.
Shut up.
Really...
Mr. Paris, there you are.
I was just leaving. Lieutenant?
I've stopped the internal bleeding and repaired the tissue damage. Your pericardium is clean as a whistle. Which is more than I can say for my sick bay.
I'm sorry about the mess. I haven't had time to clean up. It was a hectic day. I treated two broken bones, an upset stomach, and a lacerated hand.
Does this mean you're too tired to meet later? In my quarters?
Are you sure your heart can take it?
I'm detecting elevated hormonal levels. If you two don't take it easy, I'll have to declare a medical emergency.
If you'll excuse me, I have to go check on Harry. I hear he's having a nervous breakdown. It's a long story.
Not so fast, Mr. Paris. You are going to help me sterilize every square millimeter of this sick bay. No doubt you've left your oily residue on every hypo spray, your sloughed secretions on every console. Just kidding. In fact, I've had a change of heart about my fastidiousness. A little clutter never hurt anyone. Sick bay should have a more organic touch, don't you think? To help our patients feel more at home. What's gotten in there?
It's a long story.